ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. I'm your host, Kung Fu Bear. Today we're going to do something a little different. We use Microsoft Flight Simulator, hopefully with Google Maps enhancement. And we're going to go patrol the railroads. So we're going to go look at all the yards that we're in charge of in Run 8. We'll see what they look like from the air. Maybe better, maybe worse, but try to get a modern day view on everything. Well, I hope you enjoy. Sit back and relax, and let's get airborne here. All right, first on the list, we have UP stuff and Amtrak right here. Amtrak's right here, just almost below us. All the trackage for them. See the main, the BNSF main lines, the four main lines off the right here, and we're flying right over UP main lines. We have the UP LA yard and the BNSF LAC yards right here off the nose to the right. We're going to do a nice flyover of first the LA UP yard here. LA Intermodals. On the material server, Gene actually is the yard master here. About 550 feet. Cruising past it, we're doing about 110 knots. Coming up on the 710 here, Interstate 710. Right towards the south here, we'll do a nice circle back over to the BNSF LAC Hobart Yard. We'll hit the big intermodal yards first, and then we'll go searching for the smaller ones. So here off the right nose, almost the right side, is the Hobart Yard, also known as the LAC Intermodal Yard. Pretty large, nice and long. Off the left nose here, you're going to see a little bit of the LAJ and the UP River yards. The bridge that comes over from LAJ, the B yard to the C yard. And again, off the right side is the Hobart. All the main lines from BNSF. So down about 90 knots. Still about 600 feet. There's the bridge off the left nose there for CP Riddle. Takes you into the LAJ yard and the LA River yard for, is that UP? Lost my train of thought. LA West yard is right here to the right side. We'll get over there in a second after we cruise over here towards the LA River. Do the LA JA yard as well as the industries. River yards now off the left side on the other side of the river. See some cars here after the bridge goes over the LA River for LAJ. That's that's the B yard right off the nose to the right side with the bridge that takes you over to the other side. Going to do a nice orbit here around LAJ, the Industries, so you can see how it looks in real life. Episode would probably bring some grain there. See how that's processed. Going back towards the A yard. Kind of cut right through the middle of the A yard there. Now we're to the UP River yard. A bunch of UP Industries that I don't know much about here as we're flying over them now. Heading eastbound towards the LAJ C yard. Come back and look at the west on the way to Malabar. Since this is my video, I'm going to show you the BNSF yards that I know and that I am the yardmaster for. I'll show you some of the UP yards as well, but I've not spent a lot of time working them. I did City of Industry yard for a little bit when I was first getting started on the Mateos River. Working at Barstow and West Colton a little bit, CI yard, just getting stuff done. Coming to Industries now that they're serviced by the LAJ C yard. Not sure what this big open spot is in the middle. It's all satellite industry. To the left forward of us is the Commerce Yard. It's where we got a fueling depot and stuff up there a little bit more. These are some like intermodal tracks, storage tracks. You see a lot of intermodal stuff there off the right down below as well. There's the LAJ Charlie Yard right there off the right. And we're coming up on the fuel point there for BNSF. Straight ahead there, off the nose left side. Here's the industry serviced by the LAJ C yard. We'll make our way back towards the B yard. Backside of the Industries here. Taco Bell distribution or whatever it is, the industry of Taco Bell is just right there off our right. Go to the number one Mexican restaurant. Buy a Facebook poll in the United States. See me service these industries here plenty of time. Here's what it looks like from the air, though. A lot of traffic in between the industries that we don't see in Run 8. Maintaining 500 feet off the deck. Downtown Los Angeles in the backdrop. Coming back towards the LA River and back towards the LAJ E yard. Beach Freeway right here. It just crosses over the river. A lot more industries here than we're used to seeing. JJB yard right here in front of us. 324 feet off the deck. There's a crossover over the sea and back to the A yard as we head to LA West Branch. Industries here with all the crazy trackage that goes, all the different crossovers and so forth. And just down the street from it, over some of these buildings, is going to be the Malabar Yard. A bit different from the air. We're coming up on it right now, I believe. There's the yard. We'll go ahead and do an orbit. Get serviced. Cannot put run 8 has in it. So then as we continue out, if you remember, tracks do head out this way, but you can see how much cross traffic and inner like city traffic there is. All the level crossings that they have to go through. More industries here. We have an interesting, we have those two crossover tracks that didn't have any signals in it. We're keeping an eye out for them now where they are. I think they're right there. You can see them just right there off the right side. There's one. Let's go ahead and see if we can get a better look at those. Link line there. Could be UP, something UP, but I've not seen that one in run 8. Some more of those tracks that we're used to, but can you see any, I don't see any crossing down there. No signals or anything that I can tell. Just markings. That's interesting how they would stop traffic. There's signals there on this one. I didn't see any down, I don't see any on this guy over here. That's interesting. Alright, so that's Malabar. Let's go over to the Amtrak station real quick. And a bunch of UP stuff over here, again, I'm not familiar with, but you can see some trackage right there in the middle of it. That's where it comes out right there. Alameda Corridor. That's where I have a lot of stuff spawned. Okay, and then we're back here at the Amtrak station. I don't know if there's any Metro stuff done in there as well. This side is kind of the side we're on here. So there's the, it's like the engine shop that we're flying over now. Right next to LA River. That's a bunch of intermodal storage that we had on our server, but kind of took them out or don't use them, but you see Amtrak stuff. On the other side of the river there is the same thing, but for UP. Got a bunch of locomotive shops or something here. I don't know if that's Amtrak. We have to look at the map. As we come around here, it's a famous LA River Bridge that they do a lot of filming on. They film this in a whole lot of movies. It's even featured in Grand Theft Auto. I got 106 feet off the deck. 108 knots. SF mainline down to La Mirada. Well, we'll meet you there. So here's the La Mirada. It's the yard that I would call the East Yard. The middle yard is coming up. Oh, I guess that's not the middle yard. So this would be the east yard. The first one that I noticed was the middle yard. Get a look at the industries here as we orbit around. 700 feet, we'll lose a little bit of altitude here. So Santa Ana Freeway, Highway 5 on our left side. Freeway goes from Canada to Mexico. Creek here, it's a flood channel. Coming back towards the main line here. Again, off the right side here is La Mirada LMC. You might recognize the, you see where I park the trains, the locals sometimes, the switchers right here to the right side, and then the Cementex plant is right here off the right side. All these embedded industries inside of the area, pretty busy location. A lot of work to always do here. You'll see train cars on this side too. Looks like this is on the Union Pacific side. I'm not sure what yard this is. Oh no, I just lost my bearings there. This is all La Mirada. Shirt and crap facilities down there somewhere. Kitty litter places as well. There's La Mirada. Okay, now we'll continue down the line towards Palfrey. We're currently in La Mirada, which is LA County. We'll be soon in Orange County, where this helicopter basically wouldn't necessarily be, but it's okay. Right on the other side of the, there's a water channel up here. That's going to be the dividing line here. So we're currently in Los Angeles County, and we're nearly Orange County. Beach Boulevard is going to be the street that defines that. Now we're in Orange County. Going to park. Here's the Buena Park Metrolink line or station. It's Fullerton Airport here, so this is, it was right on the edge, but now we're at Fullerton. We're gonna fly right through the feather. We shouldn't, but. I think that airport's in Runway. here's the Fullerton Amtrak station, also a Metrolink station. And this is the cutoff, or not the cutoff, the junction that goes down to Anaheim and eventually down to San Diego for BNSF. Right there off the right. We're just going to continue eastbound here, BNSF-wise. And also, we are actually going eastbound magnetically. We're following Valencia Drive. Coming up on the 57 highway. This is Placentia Metrolink Station. Coming into Anaheim here. Anaheim Lake off the left. Off the left nose. I get a little bit of altitude here as we're starting to get into some hills, the Anaheim Hills area. San Bernardino subdivision of BNSF. We're going to have the Anaheim subdivision linking back up with it right here off the right side. Then that heads down to San Diego and Orange County. Currently headed eastbound towards Riverside. Four freeze at the beginning of Riverside County in a town called Corona. The street below us is called Orangethorpe Avenue. It's all the way through Buena Park, I think even La Mirada. Right up here at Imperial Highway. California 90 is the highway number. The street here, Orangethorpe, turns into Esperanza Road, which is where we're going to have the Esperanza sighting coming up right here. Continue to follow the track. Off the right there is the Interstate 91. Should be stop and go traffic for 13 miles or so. There's an interchange off the nose there to the right side again. With the 241, which is a strictly toll road. Goes down to Irvine. It's a shortcut down into Irvine and Tustin. Actually, we haven't made it there yet. Santa Ana Riverbed that we're flying over goes, it drains the mountains. There's Esperanza Siding off the left, by the way. The San Bernardino, or the river, Santa Ana River, drains into the ocean from the snow melt at Big Bear, Lake Arrowhead. There's the 241 right off the nose now. And we're just following the BNSF line right up through here. To the Anaheim Hills. Or there's three main lines. I don't remember which one it was. We've had some trains parked here before on both the Depot Plus and the Mateo server. Off the deck, we climbed through the MI Mills into Riverside County. Just here in a second. Now in Riverside County, Corona is the city here, coming up on Prado Dam in the distance. You can see off the nose. Built on the bicentennial 200 years after the country was founded. Flying right over Interstate 91 right now, as the tracks cross under it. Highway 71 here cuts over towards the 60 and the 10. There's Prado Dam right off the left now, off the left nose. Tracking the 91 here as we cross back underneath it. Coming up on West Corona. 815 feet. So we're doing about 150 knots. It's called Railroad Street. I don't know why there's water there. I guess they're having a flooding. Maybe a main blew or something. Went back towards the 91. 15 interchange isn't too far away. Goes from San Diego to Las Vegas. Porphyry. There's the Amtrak station by Porphyry. And right underneath the interchange here, you're going to see the Porphyry Yard right here off the nose. Right, we're going to hover, we're going to do a orbit over the 1591 interchange here. To the right is the Porphyry Yard. See a bunch of cars down there. There's currently a lot of construction going on here. Try to keep forward momentum in the orbit. Traffic is flowing here, which doesn't, it's usually not. So if we continue now, we're coming up on the, still in Corona, coming up on the city of Riverside. It's got districts like La Sierra, Arlington. High Grove, well actually that's, High Grove's county, but we'll continue following the BNSF tracks, the main line here east. Just below 900 feet. Nice straight track here. The main thoroughfare here, Magnolia Street, one of the main ones. It's all the way downtown. It turns into Market, but now in Riverside. Supposed to be water there, but that's what somebody sees it as. A simulator. It's just dirt. Metrolink station. La Sierra Metrolink station. An airport. It's Riverside Municipal. Small, little jets landing there. Helicopters. Riverside Police helicopter station there. Some streets in Run 8 that cross here, like Mary is one of them, but some of them, I don't remember which ones it was, but this is Mary Street right here, the Mary Street crossing. Arlington's the next one. Named after, there's some president names there. LA Fitness here on the left side. Arlington. Want to go? Should we line a workout? We're going to have the UP. It's like the interlink where the UP will attach to the BNSF lines here. Streeter Street on Run 8, but it's currently blocked out on both ends. So it's not used, but it is used occasionally. I mean, the tracks are fresh. They still roll on it. UP does on the BNSF line. That's right there, the railroad bridge you see right off the nose. Coming up on downtown Riverside here on the left. Station there, downtown Riverside. The city's off the left here. I gained some altitude here because felt like it was really low. University Riverside is off the right, a distance away over by the mountain. This is coming up as the 91 215 60 interchange, 60 to the west or 60 to the left. 91 here until the 60 and it becomes the 215. And as it continues to the right, it's also the 60 until it hits the 215 up there. It's kind of confusing. Okay. we head out towards San Bernardino, currently still in Riverside. Coming up on the county area, this is still the city of Riverside, but there's going to be a slice, High Grove, which is non-incorporated. Right here you have the UP tracks that head out towards, like, I don't know, close somewhere. You're crossing the 215 here. Remember when they put these bridges in a few years back? And Colton right now. Grand Terrace on the right, Colton kind of, oh, Grand Terrace on the left, Colton on the right, almost now. Now we're over Colton. Some altitude, those are a little bit low. So we'll be coming up on the Colton Crossing next, which you'll see the elevated platform for Union Pacific. UNSF will continue underneath it. There's the UP lines off of their nose. They are headed north-south, but in actuality, they're headed east-west by magnetic. Gonna fly right over the top of them. Go check out San Bernardino Yard first, and then we'll circle around to get the West Colton and head back up. It's all downtown-ish Colton. Big-ass Metrolink station here. I didn't even know it was there, but right off the right now, a lot of Metrolink stuff, and it connects back to San Bernardino Yard as we are flying over the West Colton Auto Yard now. It's a large auto yard. Done quite a bit of work in it. General Motors Yard. Then you'll find the San Bernardino Intermodal Yard here. Recognize some of it with all the refueling stations here. Some crossover tracks coming from UP right there, that raised trackage. So Run 8 has it down the line a little bit, but I think it was there at the smokestack here. I'm not sure what it was for. Maybe burning trash, but it says Santa Fe on it. And this is the San Bernardino Intermodal Yard. There's a whole bunch more here than is on Run 8. The Amtrak station there off the right side. Try to keep some forward momentum going. We're kind of in the edge of San Bernardino and Colton here, two cities. San Bernardino City being behind us, downtown. Amtrak station down there again. You see the Metrolink trackage here and the UP race trackage. Oh, we could follow this stuff, but I'm going to go back this way because it basically connects the Cone Pass stuff down to West Colton Yard. So we'll fly away back here and see what we have here in the way of interconnection between San Bernardino and West Colton. The crossing's still there, but they typically just go over the top. There was a derailment last year at the crossing where, like, a local derail was headed into the West Colton Old Yard. We'll take a look at that in a second as well. So here you see the three main lines, and in Run 8 there's actually a park that shoots off up. It's actually back behind us, I believe. It takes you over to West Colton. Well, maybe that's it right there. It's hard to say. That goes underneath. And indeed it does. Go right there to, that's UP track. You see the elevated platform? Google Maps kind of has it kind of mirrored, but. So there is indeed a cutoff there that goes to West Colton. Let's go look at the old yard. Right here off the nose, the right side of it, that's the old yard. Just a lot of maintenance of way stuff that is in there. There's some industry a little bit further down. Ahead of us is the 215 and 10 interchange. This is Highway 10. We're flying over, turning around next to you. That's the old yard, still in use. Now we're headed pretty much westbound. Northbound, UP would call it on their tracks, but westbound, headed back towards Los Angeles. We're in the Inland Empire now. Started the journey in Los Angeles and then made our way up through Orange County, Riverside County, now San Bernardino County. And this would be the UP, the Cajon Sub, I guess, or is it LA? I think the Cajon Sub ends. I don't remember what West Colton is part of as far as in the game. But there's the West Colton outbound yard. See the GTAX car service yard right now. We're flying over. And this is West Colton. It's outbound yard. See the hump yard up ahead a ways. Do an orbit here around the receiving or the outbound yard. Right over Riverside Avenue here in Colton. Starting to be Rancho Cucamonga, I believe. Or Rialto, it's Rialto. Receiving yard? I keep calling the receiving yard. It's the outbound yard for West Colton. Now we head up to the classification yard or the bay, the hump yard. Engine service shops. We're passing over them now, some of them. There's also more over here. Stuff in there. And there's the hump yard and a bunch of other stuff. It's a big one. I think it's bigger than Barstow. tried to take the drone to fly over on a windy day. It was somewhere here off the right next to the freeway. It's too windy though. The drone said, uh-uh. One of these little streets here I went down and I'll fly the drone and let's go over the hump yard and stuff. And nope. Didn't quite work. Alright, West Colton Hump Yard and Classification Yard. It's actually a classification yard. The hump yard is going to be at the tip of it. There would be the hump yard, that little building all by itself. Tracks connecting it. All that stuff comes here from the receiving yard. So the engine, the trains come in and they get humped from here down to the classification yard. This is what the West Coast Colton Yard looks like from the air. We'll get drone footage for it here in the future. See it a little bit better. We're just going to follow Interstate 10 westbound all the way into LA. Considered the Inland Empire as we head back towards the LA Basin. And the distance off the nose, you can see Ontario International Airport. He's staying to the, I guess the north of the runways. Be coming kind of close to it, but runways 26 are going to be free and clear of us. Fly out there a lot. We've got 268,000 pounds of fuel remaining. £268 of fuel. Not thousand. Just a railroad tonnage. This might be the Kaiser Yard here, I believe it is. Or that little the industry that with all the yard here. This is where we hit Etiwanda Boulevard. This is Interstate 15, the one that goes from Vegas all the way to San Diego again. Crossing over it now, continuing westbound following the 10. There's a better look at Ontario International Airport there, just off the left nose. the two terminals, Terminal 2, Terminal 4, Ontario. I don't know if this, I don't think this is in Run 8, even though it was there when Run 8 takes place. Smaller airport. It's from the 80s. So the 10 takes a little bit of a right turn there. It heads northwest. We continue westbound. Following the tracks here. Subdivision of UP that we're following now. There's a set of tracks off to the left that actually, I've seen a lot of auto rack stuff on that. It goes down in through Riverside to that Streeter part that we have blocked off in Run 8. Basically goes through the middle of Riverside and wraps around back to the NSF tracks that we just left. This is considered Los Angeles subdivision according to the map. Off to the left. We're still continuing to follow the Alhambra subdivision. Not sure what yard this is. Somebody wants to... This is State Street, Central Avenue. Got Mission Boulevard on our left and Holt Boulevard on our right. Vermont Avenue here. Now these have merged in the Alhambra subdivision. Is the one that we're going to follow up to City of Industry. There's one that takes a turn right up here, pretty sharp turn, and heads to the south. I'm not sure where that goes, right there off the left side. This is like downtown Pomona. We have a Amtrak/Metrolink station right here coming up off the nose. We're going to fly over it right now. Stay with these tracks here that are continuing straight instead of the ones that kind of hook a little bit to the left. That's the Los Angeles subdivision, it says. Coming into Chino and San Dimas. And 71 highways are going to mix right there off the right side. As we continue to follow the tracks now, heading south. Valley Boulevard. Cal Poly Pomona would be right here off the left where all this field is. Diamond Bar is off the left right now. Definitely back in Los Angeles County where the chopper belongs. We're out of San Bernardino County. We're back in LA, but not the actual city limits. This is just the county. And we're going to be, it's going to be a while before you start seeing the city. I'm going to go ahead and try to clear up the weather so we can actually see stuff. There we go. I took out the haze. A little bit of rain that we got today. Now we're at a good altitude. Showing about 1,200 feet, and actually getting closer to the ground here. We'll hold here, see how this works out for us. As we continue following the Alhambra subdivision, the LA subdivision is still off the left there, running parallel. Approaching the LA Basin. My map saying, little map saying that we're at just under 1,100 feet. Altimeter, which I have not adjusted at 1,000 feet, so I don't know what the altimeter setting is here. You could find out. City Industry. Here's the intermodal yard for City of Industry. Or that's actually not the intermodal yard. The intermodal yard is on the other side. We'll look at that in a moment. Oh no, this is the intermodal yard. I was looking for that little yard that that I used to work around. So yeah, that's the intermodal yard. Smaller yard just on the other side of that overpass there, and that overpass, if you remember, has like an accident site with the cow. Well, there's City of Industry, and orbit here and start heading back towards the west. Towards the west. A That's pretty cool that the buildings are shaped toward for the tracks there. Speed it up till we get back to LA. To the greater Los Angeles area. See a yard down here. past the Valley Yard, not sure. Interstate 10 is right there off to the left side of the windscreen. Cal State LA is off to the left. 710 was the highway that we kind of like dead-ended with us. This is Valley Boulevard still as we fly towards downtown in Los Angeles. North Soto Street now, coming up on Interstate 5, headed northbound as it crosses the 10. Rather large Union Pacific Yard coming up. This is downtown, I believe. This is Mission Junction. All this stuff crosses. Passenger trains. We're gonna have the LA Union Station flying towards it right now. Right off the right is LA Union Station. You can see the LA Police Headquarters, that building with the pointy top on it, right off the nose. Subdivision. And we're essentially right back where we started from. Back to Jack North of Ford, where we took off from. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tour of the San Bernardino subdivision for both BNSF and UP. Quite a large area we covered. If you've got any questions, leave them down in the comments below. There's also a link to the Mateo Discord. If you'd like to play on the Mateo Discord, please join and let them know you'd like to play. Doesn't hurt if you let them know why you're there. If you saw this video, you saw one of his, or any of mine, and that's what you're doing there. So until next time, thank you everybody for sticking through this longer video, and I hope the editing comes out good. Anyways, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one.